Good morning. Hope you're doing well. Friday morning and it's match day. Looking forward to this one. Huge, huge game at Craven Cottage. So it's time for the match day vlog. Once again, if you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you do. See those details below? Action them now. Right, Branksome train station it is, off to Waterloo, and then we're gonna get to Craven Cottage for a huge match at the top of the championship. Let's do this. Yeah, let's get on that one there. We're here with the coach's voice, Tom Jordan.
Go on, mate. He's working. Travis in goal. Yeah. Just look at that back three. If we can get Anthony just doing a bit of this today. Stacey down the other side. Gav, Lewis. Billing just floating slightly to the left. Chrissy slightly to the right. But they can do this. That's just what I like. They can do that. And they can do that. If they want to do that, they can do that as well, look. And also, Anthony and Christy can do that. We can do that.
And you can make a Christmas tree.
Oh, all sorts of stuff like that. But yeah. Travis in goal was a sound niggy.
Yeah, there you go. That's your team for tonight.
If in trouble, Mark Condes.
Here we are! We're in the big smoke, TZ. How are you feeling, buddy?
Coming here, make my dreams come true.
Yeah, it's where you can chase your dreams and get back 3-1.
Yeah. Oh, hope not.
Hope not. Big game tonight, though, eh?
Yeah, big game tonight, mate. Probably the biggest of the season so far.
Yeah.
And I am very excited for it. Tigsy couldn't be more up for this one if he tried.
Oh, good man. Right. We took the train to Waterloo. Mm-hmm. We're going to take a different form of transport to Putney Bridge. How do you fancy going on a Boris bike, on a bus, on the tube? What do you think?
I like all those ideas. What are we going to do?
Let's go by boat.
No!
Time for a montage.
Jeff Hayward Gallery.
If only he was here.
Lovely part of London.
Tom, we're at Embankment.
Yes.
Jeff Hayward is 2 minutes away and he's on the tube, one stop away. Our boat's only a couple of minutes away. Is he going to make it?
I mean, it's a race against time, but we can make him wait for Jeff Hayward, you know what I mean?
He's the chairman, right?
Yeah, he'll be fine. HMS second in the league. Let's go.
Is he going to be all right?
Yeah, I mean, if he brought your roller skates with him, he'd be absolutely fine.
Yeah, of course.
A little swim across.
There's our boat there.
There he is.
Where? Oh! Oh my god. Does he know how to do contactless? Can he do contactless? Come on, Chairman. We know you can do it. Oh, hey! He's in!
Good run, well done.
Chairman Jeff is here. Hello, Jeff!
For fuck's sake, mate.
Come in now, he's here.
So much like Eddie in that.
Yeah, he was really good. I really enjoyed that. Parker was good, yeah. I liked how he said about the young players giving him a chance because he can then mould them and stuff.
Yeah, like his philosophy and the way that he talks about it.
And he really comes across really well.
I suppose in terms of...
Parker always seems quite shifty in his words. And what he thinks is important in terms of the progression and the, you know, bringing the...
I like what he said about bringing the young
players. I think
he can mould them, and they've got they haven't got any fear, they're just going to do.
I mean, just the way he articulated his ethos. I'm sorry,
I know what you mean. Like, in terms of his mannerisms, they're very different. Yeah,
he's a lot better.
You made it then, you made it.
Yes, fitness level's never a problem, that's all I'm saying about the trains and getting here to the boat, but yes, very good.
It's a leisurely way to get to Fulham. Are we going to be leisurely on the pitch, mate? Because I'm worried about tonight, I've got to say.
I'd hope not. I think everyone should go into this game with low expectations, I certainly am. I'm just thinking of the happy days at Fulham. The 5-1 on a Friday night. 3-1 back in the 80s where we got promotion. That's what I remember Fulham for. Yeah. That's what I'm going for.
All right, mate. Balls out of the bath on this one. What is your scoreline going to be?
If it's a 0-0, I'm going to be ecstatic.
All right, let's go round and see what everyone's got to say then. Right, Hensman, what are you going for?
I went for a 3-1 to them. Yeah. I'm not enthused by this at all.
Tom has gone to the toilet, so as I just take you round the little excursion on the Uber boat, I'm just going to kneel down now and bring in this fella.
Hey,
oh, sorry, it's a random old guy. Sorry, no.
Random old guy, not. Indeed. Jeez, that's not fair. Yeah. I'm going to go with.
He's drunk all the. Drunk all the gin.
I'm going to go with. I want to be positive. So I'm going to go with a 2-1 win.
2-1 win, and there he is. He's just fresh back from his toilet break. There he is. Elias, mate, what are your thoughts about the game tonight? What's the score going to be? We're doing predictions now.
Quite positive, aren't I? I'll go, we'll nick it 2-1.
2-1, come
Steve
on.
Cook header.
I'm going for a 1-0. Dom Solanke, you went there first. Right there, mate. Team news is out. 6:45. What's going on?
It looks like a back four, mate. Travers in goal. Smith, probably left back. Stacey, right back. Steve Cook and Gary Cahill,
wow,
centre backs. Marcondes, Billing, and Lewis Cook in the middle. With Christie, Anthony, and Solanke, yes, up front. So Nyland, Meckham, Brady, Pearson, Kilkenny, Rogers and Lowe on the bench.
So the headlines are Cahill and Smith are back in. And Marcondes in from the off.
Yeah, no Kilkenny, he's dropped to the bench.
Ben Pearson cannot be quite fit then, can he?
No, he can't be. And Steve Cook giving the nod over Meckham, which is interesting as well. But yeah, Kilkenny's been dropped to the bench for Marcondes, which is also interesting. And Smith's been given the job at left back. There's no Leif Davis in the squad.
Wow, okay.
Brady on the bench instead.
Okay, there we go then.
Positive about Cahill, isn't it?
Yeah, very positive about Cahill. Him and Steve Cook as a veteran defensive partnership.
Yeah, solid against Mitro,
isn't it?
And I guess it's Steve Cook likes playing that left side. Cahill likes playing the right side, so yeah, makes sense. I'm happy with it.
Tiggs, have you seen the side?
I've just seen the side. I heard Tom read it out.
Yeah.
I'm very surprised. I'd never thought we'd see a Cook Cahill.
No.
Never thought we'd see it, but you know, looking forward to it, seeing what he can bring.
He's having a beer. Oh no, that's a soft drink. Oh no. Away day experience so far, mate. How have you found it? We've had some problems getting in the eight bells, in the temperance, and now we're in the rocket. But we've managed to get in okay, so it's all good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's enjoyable. A bit different when we got on the boat and all that. So yeah,
lovely.
Nice to mix up a little bit. But yeah, there's a few pubs we thought to go in. Both of them said they were at capacity. So big Bournemouth in town, aren't we? Do you know what I mean?
Massive
club coming. How do they cope? I don't know. But yeah, we managed to get beer in the end. And some positive team news, like we said. Some interesting ones. So yeah, a little bit more confident than I was before. Because Cahill was just a massive plus, mate.
Yeah.
And I think you don't want to underestimate Smithy as well. He can defend. And I think he'll have our
Gary Wilson, hopefully, and this could come out and bite me. But
you've seen the opposition team, and they are as strong as they can pretty much be.
Yeah, pretty much. You know, you look at it, you see Mitrovic, you see Cavallo, you see Harry Wilson, you see Seri, all the usual lot. So yeah, they'll be confident. But like we said before, the pressure's on them tonight. Yeah, let's go out there, let's grind it out, let's show some of that heart and hunger we did at the start of the season when we were struggling with injuries. Come out here at a point. We had a boat on the way here. Go home singing Super Scotty Parker.
On the bus.
On the mega bus. We better win.
Game, Jesus Christ, straight back at them, and they've got their clackers. Any club that's got them can get in the bin, absolutely in the bin. I can't hear anything from their fans. That's obviously why the club have decided to put little plastic things in their hands and it doesn't make any noise. Here's an idea, why don't you just sing, lads? All the people in the cottage. Oh, I tell you what, that was close! That was close! That's going to be a hell of a stand once it's done.
I mean, that is Steve Cook of old, that is body on the line. I think not once, twice. I mean, I think the second one is a definite goal.
Yeah.
He throws himself in front of it. I think it might have even hit him in the face.
That, oh my God. That makes you proud, my God.
Half time then, 1-1.
One all, 0-0.
We've been all right. Well, we wonder where the Fulham fans were all game. It seems like they're on the pitch and they're walking to the dressing room. How many are there? Right, half time, 0-0 then, Duncan, and it's been a bit of a weird one. We were right for the first 20. Fulham grew into it, and we've probably got Steve Cook to thank for the goal. Yeah, for the scoreline being still 0-0, eh?
That's just tremendous defending, isn't it? You know, you just want to see your defenders' bodies on the line, you know, sort of bit like the Alamo, isn't it? I mean, fair play to Cookie in terms of what he's done for us, but not sure we've got any outlet, you know, in terms of under a lot of pressure, we're putting it forward and it's coming straight back. So I think if we got away with a point tonight, we'd be really, really happy.
Here he is.
Hello.
Henchman. Mate, this light.
I was going to say, that light's really
this light's really.
Come on, let's go over it.
Perfect. You look beautiful. Mate, I don't know how to work out that half.
It was a strange one, wasn't it? Because right from the off, we couldn't really understand how Scott had set them up. So we had Don was out left, yeah. Christie was in like a false nine position, Anthony on the right. And it just was a bit, square pegs and round holes, was it? Maybe. But I don't think we've done too badly.
We've had a few chances. You've done something, you put it just wide.
Mostly on the break, though, I think.
Agreed, yeah.
Yeah.
That's his plan, though, isn't it? That's always been his plan.
I think so. Come somewhere like this, where they know they're going to dominate the ball, and they have done. That has proved to be the case. And if it wasn't for a bit of... if it wasn't for Steve Cook coming back and, you know, doing that sort of old school Steve Cook
thing. Thank you for all your podcast, man.
Oh, no worries, mate. You're on the vlog.
Hey, how are you doing? Thoughts on that half?
Mate. Yeah, it was a championship half, wasn't it? But yeah, we're going to win this fucking half, definitely.
He's sorry for swearing. Yeah. Sorry,
it's all good.
We'll take it, Cheers. Prediction?
But yeah, I agree with him. I think the longer this goes, stays at 0-0, I think the more chance we've got of nicking this, nicking a breakaway goal. You know, putting our bodies on the line. We've got this.
No! No! It's us! Flying. What happened? What the fuck happened? Dom Dom Sadaki! Dom 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 Sadaki! No way! Oh my god!
How easy was
that? Fucking hell! Fucking hell! Come off right, he hasn't set the world alight, but I tell you what, he put in a shift, some really good defensive clearances. I think he should be happy with that, should be happy, but we're happy with Pearson coming on as well. Not quite filling the Jeff hole, but he does a job.
Scott Parker, he left us your shit.
Shit, shit. I thought that was it. I genuinely thought that was in.
Top of the field.
Oh, I'm fine now, come.
We've got half hour of this.
Only half hour of this to go.
Cliff!
And Jaden.
Hey!
That's the way we like it, I like it, I like it.
Tom, you nervous yet? You nervous yet?
Fine, mate. Fine. Absolutely fine. No
at
problem
what point
at all.
Would you not take a point?
Now. Now. We'll win this.
What's it, like 70, how many minutes?
77.
Yeah. All right.
Drag it on.
We now no longer want to take a point.
I'll take it. We got this. Come on!
It's Fulham free kick. Fulham goal.
We are riding our...
Just a bit, mate. I'm loving it, though. 81.
Are you actually loving this?
Oh, I'm not loving it, but I'm loving every chance they miss. Mate, I'm taking this on 81 minutes. Was it up? Take it, mate. Keep going out. Come on!
I mean, we're presenting space. We are presenting space.
Go.
Fulham have won the FA Cup.
After a long 20 minutes.
And you know what? You could see it absolutely coming. We said it on here. The family stand are on their feet. With their clackers. It's funny how goals change games, and look, now we might actually give it a go, or will we just do exactly the same? I bloody hope not.
We'll take that, eh? We'll take that.
How are you, buddy?
I'm really good tonight. We've got Fulham fans chanting, they're top of the league, and they can't beat our fucking reserves!
Away day has nearly come to a close. We're back to Victoria.
We get the mega bus home, mate.
It would have been so much better
mega,
if we are on, wouldn't
mega it? Bus.
Should we have a pint?
Yeah, actually, it's not quite finished yet. There's time for another one. Come on,
go.
Are you drowning your sorrows? Are you drowning your sorrows?
No, I was just having a little look around Twitter.
Yeah.
A little Twitter, trying to find the video that you can't load on your
phone. I'm trying to load up the goal. Apparently, what is it that Jamie Carragher has said? It's the best.
Describe it as best goal you'll ever see from a kickoff.
All over them.
First two things.
All over them.
Did they get? Did they touch the ball in this game?
That was a great chance.
Yeah, he's dragged it.
You know, Sammy D does that.
Yeah, this was the Mitrovic one.
Oh, yeah, Steve Cook.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
One face, two face.
Wow.
Two face Cook.
Steve Cook. Dynamite.
Legend.
Oh, I'll tell you what, I love him more than most of my family. Sorry, Dad. That's unreal. That is unreal.
Wow.
Bing bang. What a goal.
That's a great finish.
That is sick.
And that run that he did as well. He did know where it was going, to be fair, didn't he?
You go to like say something, you ain't going to make that number if you know it's going to
Gallagher.
I thought it was him.
So then, Tom, we stay abreast of Fulham. We stay abreast of them. And
we do.
One all.
Yeah.
Hang on.
Have you not recorded anything there? We have to start again. Oh, hello. Always.
You know what? You've got that.
Saying hello to Morgan.
I've seen that somewhere before. I've seen that somewhere before. But mate, it's.
Hang on a minute.
You just got me in to talk about the game, and then you went, it's right, Tiggs is here. Let's bring him in.
Yeah. Well, you carry on, Tiggs. What did you think of the game?
Yeah, it was alright, wasn't it?
Yeah.
However, a semi-successful away day, eh?
Yeah, we've said it a lot, haven't we? We would have taken a point before. It's a little bit frustrating, but yeah, it was all right. And yeah, we're fine about it. We're still up there. A few tough fixtures tomorrow, which I hope you do us a favour. Yeah. Like, what was it, Coventry West Brom, they can't both win. So yeah, we were decent tips.
Who is this guy? So Tixon, what can people do if they like the channel?
They can like this video. Yeah. Subscribe, please, so you get
press the bell as well, the little bell
bing,
thing.
Bing, 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 bing. So you find right. out when the next one's coming. And you can also tell all your friends and share this post on any of your social media outlets that you have available at your fingertips there.
Can I carry a pigeon?
I carry a pigeon, I love it.
He's done that better than I ever could, to be
fair. The challenge.